I'm curious, since taxes got paid, let's go through here and just see. Everybody's a little poor. Some people have no gold. So you can see we got a bunch of meat here. I'm not going around right now. I'm just gonna go put this in different places, but for the time being, I'm just gonna dump all the meat right in here. Up to 10. 10 is where I try to cap it. Like these pies here, try to have 10 of each pie. There we go, we got 10 veggie, 10 meat pies, and 10 berry pies. Torches are being sold because I haven't sold one yet. You know, I imagine you'd be sitting there and get stuck late at the tavern, need to find your way home. Hey, you even need a torch, kind of like a light, you know? You got caught out after dark, so there you go, why not sell one? What have we been doing? Buying meat? Yeah. Been buying berries, that's good, I don't mind. That's good to do. More meat. Haven't been selling anything in that last little area. It did, it wasn't showing up. So we got some more meat there. Plenty of veggie pies. I'll keep that for later. Everything else looks good? Alright. So now I'm gonna show where you find the taxes. So this is City Hall right here. You're gonna go upstairs. I believe it's, yep, see there? There's that little money, means tax collector. Sometimes I think they're in here too. This little, any of these others? No. Yes, this one right here in the corner. Manage chest, and then down here is the gold. So you can already see they've taken some of their wages out of that. And I can put more gold in there if I want, but I only have two people working. Later when you have like an army, the reason you don't want to start an army like right away to start taking over, because somebody asked me they wanted to see that, I have to build a thriving town first with people in it before I have enough resources to have an army that will be successful enough to overtake another settlement nearby. So, one step at a time. But I will get to that. I will show how to do siege engines and how to attack and even take over. I'll go to war with somebody here, take over their kingdom, and I'll have two settlements under me, under my rule. So here we go, we go to this map here. Oh, didn't mean to do that. And with this, you can create a war camp, and what that will do is that will set up here, and you'll need a general and whatnot. And then that's where your army will start collecting here, and you have to pay them whether they're fighting or just sitting, you have to pay them, so that's why I don't do it right now. Then you can send your army somewhere else. There's also, if you have a diplomat, you can use a diplomat on the screen and send one to establish trade routes. I don't think that part's working in the game yet, though, but that's how it's going to be set up. So you'll have a map of, like, you know, a generic map, and then you'll take it, and it'll take it to the map screen, and you can do different things like that. Where is my sword? Is this in here? I do need to eat something though. There we go. I'm so glad to get out of these peasant clothes. There's my horse trying to get me, reach me. Come on, horse. You're alright. Come on. There we go. Okay. What was I doing next? So I can't do the clothing. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go and show you why I've been looking at everybody on here to find out who I have in here. Because now, I need go find somebody that's going to teach, train me some stuff. So I'm going to be looking in the specialization column here. What I'm looking for is a hunter. Trader, hunter. Here we go, right here. And this, perfect. So see this guy right here? They're down on their luck, got no gold, doesn't have any gold. He can teach me something that I need to know. And then he's going to help me and I'm going to be helping him. And by doing that, we're going to be both helping the settlement here. I ran out of stamina there. Oh, I do need to go sleep. Is this his house? Ah, he's broke but not poor. He has a house. He's sleepy. Alright, you know what? That looks good. I think I'm going to go take a rest since I cannot regain my stamina. I think my house would be right down here somewhere. Yeah, you can stop and nothing adds. That's what happens when... my horse at? It'd be quicker if I just jump on the horseback and go down there. There we go. Much better. But yeah, you can't rest, you can't do, I mean, you have to sleep, basically. And you only need to sleep, since it's like daytime. I'm just gonna go sleep for like an hour. And that will give me my vigor back. And then having vigor, when you stop to rest, then your stamina will come back. As you can see, the blue bar in the upper left there, above your health, that is totally gone. So 1 hour here. 9 in the morning. It's gonna save. The blue bar goes away, and here we go. So we got 99. And you can already see my energy shooting up there. Alright, so now I gotta go find that person again. So I can now do it at a run. Since I'm here, might as well cook some of this meat. Yeah. Might as well. I had some wolf. I'm gonna use that wolf meat. Okay, cool. We'll just use the rest and make meat pies. At 1,444. Man, the population is growing here. Alright. Oh, good. It's daytime. Yeah, hate it when it's like. We're gonna go walking around, everybody's asleep, we can't reach them, can't find them. I think you can wake people, up, but nah. I wanna kinda somewhat simulate this as how it would be. You really wouldn't wanna do that unless it's a good reason to. So let's find this guy. Hunter, here we go. Still at zero goal. We're about to make his day. We have something to pick him with. Where's he at? Is he at the shop? Yeah, he's up there. Okay. Good. Hello. Can you teach me anything? Yes, I want to learn that. You know what? I need to learn skinning too so I can make the armor. I do have the gold. Boom. So we just made him 3,500 gold richer. So... we just put a big boost to this to the economy here. Yeah, you see seller go 10,000 39. That's all the total of all the settlers, all their gold. Like, this column totaled up. So, yeah, he's the rich. Just made him the richest guy in town. What is that other guy? What does he do? A trader. Aha. So, this tells me if there's another trader here. But he doesn't have a shop. Okay. So, yeah, if I haven't explained this column here yet, the first column is what they own, this person owns. So, the first one is they own a house in town. So, you can see who still needs a house. This is the shop. So, if they have a shop, it's going to be right here. And a shop could be just like the stonemason place up there. I think that those are considered shops as well. But I don't really know how they make money unless they go there as a stonemason, cut the stone, and then sell it in someone else's actual shop. That might be it. Okay, so I'm quite poor now, but I can go make my armor, which I'm going to go do. The fighting. So what we need to do now... swordsman. I think we need to find, and this we'll do one because I don't think I have any training in the sword. So let's do that and help this person out here. I should have at least 5. Yeah, and you can kind of tell swordsmen because they're all dressed in some kind of armor that the others don't have. What do you want? You want cut stone? No, that was 50 gold. Nice. What can you teach me? Novice swordsman, 500. Yes. Here we go. I do have 1,000, but I need to keep it for my shop, so... And I have plenty of learning points. But if I go here... got that one, and then right here, a novice swordsman, so I can at least do some damage with the sword. I think I also might, that also might play into, or maybe not, maybe it's a button that allows to build better weapons, but let's go get my armor. Here we go. So, I'm gonna need, let's get a leather helm. I can build a Kirkus yet. Trousers. And then I'll need 15 leather, which I can get. Let's go in here because I'm going to sell what I don't wear. Yeah, that's good. What are you doing in here? Okay. Oh great. I do have more leather. And I will go do that. Yes, as soon as I add a little bit more gold in here. 500. I can leave that there for now. Alright, so let's get my helm and that on. Let's see. Helmet, there we go. Got a helmet on there now. And we got... There we go, leather pants. That's better. So that replaces the poor man's bottoms that we got. Okay, cool. Let's put that for sale somewhere. I don't know if these ever get sold, but I'll put them here just in case. There you go. And then, yeah, you need to go the other way around. Wait, no. That's the inventory. What? Oh, that's storage. Okay, yeah. There we go. Okay. That kind of switched around there. I'm curious, by the way, why am I losing so much gold? What are they buying? Let's see. So I'm selling trees some, which is good. Selling that. Should be making. I'm buying leather. Okay. Well, I need the leather, so that's fine. I'm definitely making good use of it. Okay. That's fine. I'll make my top here. There we go. Now you can see my guy. Yeah, that looks much better. So now I'm not like a pauper running around trying to run things. Okay. Poor man's top, throw that in there. Alright. I just made some rich. I checked the boards now. 10:34. They're already spending their money. So that's what's amazing about this game that I like is the economics. You can actually see down to the individual, which I've always really appreciated in a game. And not many actually can do it like this, which was a strong draw to me for this game. But you can see right here is the hunter who I paid. He hasn't spent much here. I still need to find out that trader. Where is he? What is he up to? And then the swordsman. That's not him. Where's the other swordsman? Is that him right there? This might be the other swordsman, I think, right there. He's already spent some of half his. Oh no, it was 500, wasn't it? So he only got 500. That's right. Okay. So yeah, they're rich. I got. Coin in their pocket so that they can go around and buy stuff. And since I kind of have a monopoly on the shops around here, they're just going to spend the money right back with me. But as other shops start springing up, you'll have competition, and yeah. And that's actually a good thing because you can go in and buy stuff that you're looking for in the other shops. Okay. Got meat here. Well, look at that. Yeah, yes. Alright. So that's what happens when you dump a whole bunch of meat in there. There. Bread's good. Yeah, okay. And let's take some profit. Which will allow me to do more stuff. Now that I have that. Did it. Let's see. No, that's it. Okay. So that's kind of like running a real business where you just go in and scalp off, you know, operating costs, leave that there in the box, I guess, for operations, and then you will have your funds. Let's see. There we go. That's one answer. That's what I'm looking for. Block is the right mouse button. Left click is to attack. I think it also has to go your direction. I think it was Skyrim or Mountain Blade kind of. I think Mountain Blade does a similar combat style depending on your approach. Anyways, take that away. And how much gold did I get that? Okay, let's eat. Gonna go and find the other swordsman. Yeah, he's got okay. Already helped him out. I'm gonna kind of try to spread the wealth around a little bit. There we go. Another swordsman right here. He's been here longer. I think the longer that they have been in your town, I could be wrong, but I think the longer that the NPC has been in your town, the higher up this list they'll be up here, and it just amends it to the end there. as the new ones come. There we go. Oh, you're coming to sell stuff. Let me help you out here. You can teach me something, yeah? Yes, I do. There you go. Happy days. Yeah, so when they're carrying a box on their shoulder like that and walking like that, they're heading to the shop to sell stuff, so you can kind of tell. They got something they're selling, which is cool. Alright, so let's look at my perks now. Yeah, we're good. Oh, I got the skinner. Forgot I did that. Yeah, so I can go and skin. So when I hunt animals, I can actually scan and get hides from them to make leather. So, yeah, I'm gonna find the archer. I think it's gonna cost me 1,000, but let's find the archer. Like making my folks rich. Okay, so he already has 500. Let's see if there's another archer that needs more help. 400. What these archers are doing? 89. Well, we'll go to the 89 one. I think they may be the ones actually going out. The archers are. Or maybe it's the hunters. No, maybe the hunters are doing it. I don't know where the archers are spending that money. Guy's way out here. Oh, you want stone? Okay, sure. I made 25 gold off that. Teach me. 1,000, yes. Ah, he's 1,000 gold richer. So let's see. So what that means with the archer, let's see. This gives me a 10 plus range damage. Huh. Well, it's not listed there, but I think your archery skill also depends on what weapons that you can use, but it's not registering there. So I'm gonna go over here. I think it also may link up to what weapons you can make. So now that I got like basic archery, I should be able to make a better bow and arrow. Let me see here. What do I got currently? I have a wooden short bow. I prefer to use a longbow because we have a bit more reach and damage. Let's see what we got. They just have a regular wooden bowl. So they have the self wooden bowl. That's what you start with. That is the short bow, the next one up. Ah, okay, so the perk is tied to your carpentry. Alright. So then I'll be able to make the wooden bow, and I think that's the best bowl. Over here. Okay. So you know what I can do, though? Make a couple of these. Oh yeah, I'm showing you a glitch there. So when you're, don't change these up here when you're crafting, because whatever you change it to, it'll start crafting under that item. So what I did is I actually was crafting a wooden short bow, and I clicked on the wooden arrows just to get ready to craft those next. And so it was already crafting. It didn't stop crafting the short wood bow, and it started crafting wooden arrows. So yeah. Most times you don't want to do that, so keep that in mind. Light, there we go. You give a little bit of gold this time. Alright, there we go. Oh, somebody bought the pants? Yeah, look at that. Someone bought the pants. Nice. Okay. You know what? Manage shop. I don't know who's doing it, but I think somebody's coming in here selling me saddles, and I got plenty of saddles now. Nope, I took that off, so that's not what it is. Let's see, what are they selling? Seeds, that's fine. Leather. Yep. About to cut that leather off, though. Since I can make it myself now. Oh, anyways, what I was going to show you is that, yep, I can go here because I only need one bow. And I can now sell these, the bows that I made. And then the arrows, too. I'm going to be doing some hunting, so I'm going to keep 40 of them. Just put 3 in there. So I got some arrows to sell. And the same thing when you're crafting on your weaponry as well. You can sell that. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna go over here and go to sleep for a little bit. Okay. Just trying to guess on the time that I have right now. What I can get done in this episode. Craft a little fox. I don't know if I showed this, but I'm gonna show it again. So the table there is where you roast your meat. And if we come up here, there's this little, oops, I think I showed it before, but there's this little bakery. I wish you could bake pies, because I do a lot of pies, but all you can actually bake is some bread, so I'll do 2 loaves of bread while I'm here. We're at 1,485. Nice. Okay. Put that out, so we got these daytime around here. So anyways, 4 in the morning, we'll sleep for about 5 hours. Fine, there we go, sleep. Cool, that will save it and rest me up, give me my vigor back, which is going down. Alright, cool. So with that, I'm going to take an early little break here. I will be right back. Yep, I'll be right back.
ただいま、全11地帯から925地帯へ向かっております。
Alright, we are back. There we go. All good. Level 18. Oh, I wanted to say something. Unknown peasant still. So you can still dress him up, make him look good, but you actually have to do stuff in the game, in the realm, to actually get your title to go up. One of those is going and defeating bandits. So, double check before I go do it. I got my archery there. And it's gonna be down here. What did I put on? Hunting as well. Let's, yeah, there we go. Yeah, so my. Let's see, your melee attacks are 10% stronger, combat energy recovers 2 times faster. That's good. I don't remember where I left the horse, so this is also helpful for that. Here we go. Alright, so now. Oh, a new settlement was established. Okay. A future place for a tavern. I didn't mean to stop here, but I do see less pepper. I always need pepper. Now, so there's a deer. Now you'd be asking, why am I trying to chase a deer down on horseback with a sword? Well, that's a good question. And the answer is that it's really hard until you level up your perk a little bit more. The shooting with the range on the bow and arrow. So I don't know, I didn't intend to do it this way. I did, you know, would imagine just shoot maybe from horseback even with a bow and arrow, which I think you can. But this ends up having better results just doing this. So I think I just landed a hit. We'll get closer, we'll see some damage. Is it or not? This part never gets easy. Jeez, and now he's gone. So this is another reason why, you know, that might be a move that I will, you know, buy leather and open it for meat as well. Because yeah, the NPCs have a much easier time with this than I do. There he is. Okay. There we go. I bloodied him. I saw that. I think it's maybe two or three more hits. It might be done. This is embarrassing. I haven't killed anything in this series yet. Too slow. You will notice a bit of a latency here when you're trying to maneuver and do all this stuff as well as fight. There we go. Good thing is just to get like a good running, but the deers are really bad about, I guess, really good. Turning at the last minute on a dime and just going the other direction. But this guy's chasing me now. Okay. Come on, I want to get at least one deer. Oh, I'm streaming. Come on. Yeah, and with the clipping of the graphics, they can run out of clipping real quick. And then you can actually lose what you're heading for like that. I saw a deer over there. It's hard to tell though if that's the deer I've been after. That's a new deer. Oh, that was the same deer. Cool. So then, before I ran away, stop horse, jump off the horse. Come over here. And loot. And you can see I got two deer meat, some deer antlers, and the skin. By learning all those other perks, that's what I got from it. Okay, so now he's been looted, skinned, and harvested. Okay. Oh yeah, you can't get on your horse holding anything in your... Might be both your hands, but at least the right hand. You can't. So, finally did it. Huzzah. That's a wild horse there. But for hunting, like in that method that I use, yeah, that's one harder. So what happens when you're doing bow and arrow? I'll try the bow and arrow to show you. And I might have to get on foot because I think it's actually easier to shoot with the bow and arrow on foot. But you'll hit the creature and then they'll run off. And because there are already, you've got distance between you, unless you're on horseback, it's gonna be kind of hard to run up on them, chase them down. And it's a lot easier to lose them, and you've already pumped like one or two arrows into them. So, and if you miss, I mean, you miss. That's also, you have to craft your arrows. There's not like unlimited arrows in this game. It's not like you can just, you know, keep shooting with unlimited ammo. Each arrow that you shoot, you've actually had to craft, or you've bought one from an NPC who's crafted it. Now we've got something over here. Now if this is a bandit lair, which I think it is. Oh, what is this? Oh, is that oh, I think that's snow. Here is you have to put your arrows in one hand and then the bow in the other. Yep, and of course you can see I have my bow up now. Yep, so now I can shoot. I can hold and shoot. So, oh, there he is right there. Oh, he went back. This game's a little buggy, like where stuff appears and disappears. Ah, oh, there he is, right there. I'm gonna see if I can shoot him right inside there. Nope, missed him. Let's see if I do it again. There we go. Be great if I could destroy him without. And do parlay. Ooh, I killed him. There we go. So, what you do, I'm going to want to go, where's my sword? There we go. Sword and torch. Gotta put that away. So since I can't, now there could be other bandits around, and since I'm streaming this, I'm going to show you, but the female, Whoa, she had a bunch of stuff. Okay, so what did she have? She had a fancy Richmond's hat, Richmond's bottoms, Richmond's top. And Richmond's shoes. So I'll be able to get some of those. I think these iron... No, these are not iron. Because did I make iron arrows? I don't think I made... These are wooden arrows. Okay. So, yeah. But I'm going to take all. There we go. And I don't think there's ever anything in here. I only looked around a couple of times. Not each and every one. But I don't think there's anything. I think this is all for looks. But depending on how long the bandit lair has been around, I think there could be more bandits in it. Oh, wait. Bandit storage. Oh, it doesn't belong to you. Okay. I've never... Oh, that's cool. I didn't know that was there. You can actually play a bandit in this game, too, and rob, you know, rob from everyone and make your bandit lair. And you, I think you can add other bandits, right, to your lair. Jolly robbing band of bandits, if you like. But anyways, I have the torch in hand. Bring it up. There we go. And I can hit X, and now it will destroy bandit lair. Oh, I gained sergeant perk from that. Wow, that's cool. So the bandit lair on the right, my fame went up 25%, and my global reputation went up plus 250. Now, if I do this, you can see that I am no longer a peasant. Oxgillenhide is considered an ordinary farmer, level 18. So that's how you level your title, right there, is through combat like that. And, yeah. That should get cleaned up later on. Alright. Like this. This is my staple food that I just eat a lot of. I'm going to spend some time to grab it here. What are these? More peppers. Always use more peppers. You know, the funny thing is, I only think I've seen peppers in any of my taverns, not in this game, but in other games. I've only seen it maybe bought once from the tavern. So there's no rule book for this game, so you just kind of, you know, talk to other people and see what they know. There is a Discord out there. If you go to the stream discussions on Steam and look for somewhere in there should be a link to the Discord. You can come on the Discord and ask questions and people will help you. And that's where I also post some of these videos, which you may be watching now, that you saw it posted there. I'm gonna get these. The Boston Fern and then the Azalea, those are used for making medicinal plants, which are aka healing potions. It's just how I think. This nice vista. Let's look out. See if there's something around the hut. Oh, there is a. I don't have it, do I? Oh, that might be that building there. Don't feel like chasing my horse down. Oh boy. There we go. I'm gonna go investigate that town. Might be one that I've already discovered. I see something up there. Yeah, I think it is, actually. But one good thing about going into the town is looking for a trading post. I still need to find salads and salad seeds. So maybe I would have them by now, but I'm not letting the other traders get started just yet. So what is this? That's a house. Yeah, it's a house, okay. Well, I should have a tavern in here somewhere. There it is. Yes, might as well check up on the tavern while I'm here. No customers. Alright. There we go. Need to add some more gold to it. And after all that training, look, I am running low on gold. Yeah. But I do got some raw meat there, you know? Bread. We're good on bread. Me. There you go. Is that all I have? It is roasted fox. How funny. Okay. Let's take one of these back. I think I have one in there. There we go. Six. See what the shop's been doing. So they bought meat, bear meat, bought berries, fox meat, deer meat, meat, and berries. I haven't been selling very much. That's why it came as empty. But it's gonna be that way in the beginning. It's gonna be kind of like that. Now that I put more gold, they can come and they can expand and grow. What I'm looking for, though, if that's a common house, is a trading post out here. That's what I want to find. And usually they will not, the way this works is that they will not build their shops until they have a house to live in first. So, and this is not, not really adding, contributing that much other than the tavern, my own tavern in the place. I'm not going to add anything to, so these guys are going to have to develop on their own. There's another deer, but I'm not ready for a marathon, so let him be for now. This really does look kind of like at a glance. Wait, I think it is. Wait. I think that is a tab, a shop. I don't know, maybe not. What is this right here? I'm gonna destroy this structure. Let's go inside and look. Nope, this is somebody's home. Okay. Yeah, these are homes here. So, okay. Can hit M, we'll bring up the map. This will show me where I'm at. There's another bandit slayer if I want to take that on. Where's my place? My place is over there. Okay. We got some bandit layers over there. Let's put that bandit layer on the map. We'll take him. That was really good. That saved me the trouble. I was going to try to find the soldier or somebody to train me to become the sergeant, but just doing combat here, I was able to do that. So some of these are really well armed and really well have nice armor, so you don't want to get anywhere near them. Okay, so see if I can get them from afar without having to parlay with them. They basically will start chasing you and let's see. And so far most of these there's only ever been one. Somebody wanted us a deer walking around. You'll see if it happens, it kind of warps you over to them. Which I really hate. And it makes you, disarms you, or your weapon disarms you, so you like, you can't do anything. I don't know where the heck are they now. I'm sensing a pattern here. Let's see. Can I hit him from here? Damn, my mouse is really touchy. There we go. Oh crap, here we go. Well, this one's coming after me. But what you can do. Yeah, what other. Oh, mountain blades like this too, where. Yeah, you can get them in combat. Never turn your back on an opponent. Come on. There we go. Yeah, I got him. That was easy. Alright, dismount. Let's get our sword and torch back in hand. Swords, there we go. What do you got? Peasant hat, wild tomato, iron light. Goodness, that might be better. Nope. Stuff I can sell in about 400, okay, so that's good. Can't get the sword though. Maybe it's just. I don't think you can get the weapon, which is disappointing. Oh, come on now. Alright, so we'll get back, stand back. Destroyed! Reputation 250, and my fame grew by 25. Well, I can make nicer swords once I get my bots moving up. Anyway, okay. What have we got here? A whole bunch of nothing. Sometimes small, like rabbits and foxes and stuff you can find, but they're like really small and low on the ground, so you can mess them real easy. You know, check. Time to check around for him. And the pelt of a fox is a quest item that's usually reserved for like leaders. I don't know if they switched that out, but it was always good to have that couple of fox pelts around. So what I would like to find next, and they're fairly easy to get, are buffalo. Bears, and for now, I'm just going to avoid until I have better armor, I'm going to avoid fighting a wolf or a bear, even on horseback. It's like, they can kill your horses, so. I prefer not to risk without the horse's head, you're running on foot, and they can catch up with you, especially the wolf. So I'm just going to wait to have better armor to go after those guys. There's another town, maybe, that I've seen. That'd be a great place to put a shop. Oh, I hate how some of these are just hanging. Takes you out of the game when you see stuff like that. So nobody has really built any shops yet. What is this here? Is this a... No idea what this is. It could be a shop. It's like people are coming in here to sell stuff. There's an unknown seller. Let's see. Nice to meet you. Anti-robbery mission. I'll go see your meter. Nice to meet you. I'll go see the leader. Believes the head of the settlement wants to entrust me with some task. That's funny. Oh, I got plenty. Yeah, look at that. Some of this bandit funds back into the economy here. Yeah, let's do that. Stuff when I created this tavern. I didn't even have peppers. Oof. What is the difference between that? Berries? Oh, a different kind of berry. That's wild. Alright. Whoa, that's a lot of deer meat. Man, okay. So I'm gonna go find this guy. I'll hopefully get a quest to eliminate a nearby bandit camp since I'm a little bit more confident in my abilities to combat now. Let's search him out, see if I can find him. Here he is, where's he at? Because I was told. There's an assignment for me. Go and kill all the bandits in nearby band layer, burn down their house, destroy all their buildings. Alright. I haven't done it like this before. I don't think I've destroyed a bandit layer as part of a quest. I came here. Okay, cool. Alright, so there it is. It's in the skull and little Jolly Roger looking icon there. Go and prospect, that's it. Mm-hmm. It has this phantom, like the. I don't know why that happens, but the compass has like this phantom thing where things appear where they're not actually there, so you just kind of gotta look around a little bit when that happens. Usually means you're getting close, but. Can't just go off that. Which time? And so you can see the question mark on the compass at the top. And then, of course, up on the map means it's been selected, so it shows up at the skull and crossbones there. Which indicates a bandit lair. So I think I just need to defeat this guy. Okay, we made it to the bandit lair. I'm gonna armor myself up here. What is that? Ooh, iron arrows. I just use these. right there by the wall on the window. Can I shoot through windows? I wonder. Find out. And that didn't hit him. Looked like it did though. That should hit him, definitely. Alright, so that's a little annoying. Should be able to shoot through windows, damn it. I know I can shoot the doors. Go. He did not like that. My horse should get killed. And he's down. Kill the bat. Global reputation went up 100. Fame went up by 5. Okay. Loot. What do you got? Anything? That's kind of what I got. Got a buffalo skin. That's cool. Okay. I think I had some better armor earlier. I need to go back and look at this. That's Richmond's Bottoms. No. So mine give me a 5%? 3%? Okay. And an iron light compass. What do I got here? That's 10. This is better armor right here. So I'm going to put that on. There we go. Other trousers. 5, 2, 3. All right. Nobody in there. Alright. And destroy and step back. There we go. That layer killed, burned the building. Okay. I was curious, what is mine? Oh, I am a famous soldier now. I think that's not the 3 bandits. Alright, so you're kind of. There he goes. I think that was a fox. There he goes. It's actually easier to hunt these on foot. You gotta kind of pace out your stamina. So there's the fox skin and the meat. might be a wild horse up there. So I now need to return to that town to turn in that quest. Fox out of that. That's funny. So the mayor of the town is waiting in my tavern. The local hangout. Cool. Alright. I came to the town this evening. Please that he had watched and trust me with some tasks. Yeah, there's another. I don't know if that was an error or what. Looks like he just gave me the same task again. But hey, look, I got a lot of meat in here. Here's some more gold. What have we been doing here? Yeah. See, when you're at not your town, right? And everybody's like just starting, everybody's gonna come to your tavern and just sell whatever they can get. And so you're always gonna constantly, until the town builds up, becomes more stable, you're gonna always be adding gold and taking meat for the most part, and then stocking it with other stuff for people to buy. Eventually they'll have enough money, they'll start buying that stuff too. Yeah, let's go. I'll be here a while. Might as well. Well, we're getting close up there. So what happens at 2048, no more settlers will be added to the island, which means no new influx of gold coming in. But of course you have wars, wolves can kill them. Things can happen that will end the settlers' lives. And so, you know, through that, once they die off, I don't know how many it is, or if it's a set limit, or if it's a set time, but they will start bringing in additional people will start showing up after that. I got so much deer meat. There's another 14 settlers. One of those cases, I gotta be careful. What is that? Fox meat? Yeah, my figures on, my health. I need to. There's a cabin. There we go. And I'm gonna sleep for an hour. Let's go save and get my figure back. Good. Yeah. Couldn't make some meat pies, but I'm just not gonna worry because I don't have the bakery that I feel like building right now. Let's roast all the meat, and then I'm gonna go put it back in here. Ah, good, made a little more meat. I'll take this with me. They did buy some peppers, I think. I think they may have bought peppers. That'd be cool. Didn't buy anything else. So let's start adding here. Wolf meat, yes. Rare meat, yes. Heaps of this. I'll put 5 here, yeah. Place for now. Let's see what this is, huh? Oh, this is a house, okay. And you can also check and see how these areas are doing by going to their... In fact, this is the only place on other NPC settlements. It's going here and checking, you can see. So they got 20 settlers, houses, 24, they're very rich, and that's the only information you'll get. I think if you become more friendly with the mayor, you might get access to more information. It might reveal more details to you. But that might not be right either. Okay, so these guys are all building their homes. Hopefully we'll have the trading post show up here for too long. I'm gonna look at my map here. Just go there. I don't think I've been to here, so let's go that other little place. I'm not really traveling too far. I think when you go on the maps now, it looks like it kicks you off the horse. That's interesting. I don't think it did that before. But while we're riding through the forest, let's do some crafting. Oh, there's that thing where I switched it again. Alright. I don't know what just happened. Am I here now? Well, that's a tavern right there. Oh, I think you built it. Alright, I ain't gonna worry about that. What I'm going to do a little cooking here. $1,548. Get on up there. Save, restore my vigor. Alright, cool. What's going on here? This place has 16 settlers. And they're rich. They get money. Okay, good. I like to think that my little tavern here has helped people prosper a bit.
And then, Silver, what are you eating? What are you hungry for?
3 loaves? Alright. Victor Reach, are you still hungry? There's your bread.
Yeah, 10 gold.
Can you teach me anything now that I'm here? Architect, nah. Try to keep that gold in your own settlement. Train with your own people is what I highly recommend. There we go. See how we're doing here. We're not making any money at all, just selling meat and we're buying meats and buying berries. That's what we're doing. Yep. Alright. As to be expected until this tavern gets up on its feet more. But that's also because I didn't have as much stuff in there to sell. Now that I have some meats and some pies and all that, should start coming around. The thing is that the settlers have to have that amount of money on them to be able to purchase that. So, yeah, this place needs to be doing. What's this place has a trading post? Things will be better. What is this? Keeps looking like a trading post, but it's not. Ah, yes, the same building I went to last time, please. It's very similar to one of the trading posts. Where am I at anyways? This was... Oh, I'm not even in the right place. How did I end up here? This is the place I was wanting to go to. I just ended up going there again. I thought that looked familiar. Okay. So, yeah. I got distracted a minute from the like crazy crafting going on. This is what I ended up. What I ended up with? 84 planks, that's good. I still got 58 that. How many arrows do I have? 60, yeah, that's plenty. Yeah, I'd say at minimum you want to go when you do any hunting or fighting or anything, you want to have at least minimum 10 arrows on you at all time when you're doing the range. Because you can miss a couple of times, and when they're moving targets it's a lot harder to hit them when they're just kind of stuck there. What is this, a bandit? Oh, these are getting harder to resist. I thought that deer was something coming at me. Alright, let's do this. This guy looks like he has some nice armor on. Might actually be metal armor. Let's see if I can get a shot in there. Here we go. Yep. He is not happy. does a little weave. Oh, I think the sword is blocking those. I've not seen that before. You don't run into any like obstacles or anything like rocks or trees. You get stuck there and he'll start waylaying on you and kill your horse and you. Oh man, this guy's harder to get. There we go. Yeah, it takes a lot more arrows to get this guy because his armor is good. I definitely want to get this guy because his armor is going to be really good. And this is actually the easier way to get good armor. You don't have to go through all the pain of like trying to buy it or make it yourself. Oh, how many arrows is it going to take to get this guy? There we go. Oh, that was heaps of arrows. Them though. Okay, where the heck is he? There he is. Alright. So what does he got? Plate armor legs? Yes. Plate helmet? Yes. Torso plate? Let's just take all. Good. Alright, so, plate legs, there we go, that is awesome. Plate torso, there we go. Not a leather helm, let's do a plate helm. That is sweet. Wooden short bow, didn't he have a bow? He just had a normal bow, okay. Oh wait, boots. Plate feet. There we go. Nice. So now I got a bucket helm with a plate mail. Alright. There we go. We're not done yet. There we go. Bandit's lawyer. Was destroyed. The lair was destroyed. Okay, so what am I now? I'm a famous soldier still. Okay. This is awesome. That, I think that might be the best armor in, currently in the game. Just need a better sword now. Okay, so where was I headed? I was headed to that other. There we go, I was headed over here. Touchy mouse. Wait a minute. Well, we'll come back out here in a second. Yep. Looking. Oh, this place actually. I don't like this, all the trees in here. This place might actually have a trading post right now. What is that? Is that buffalo. Oh crap, there's a wolf out here too somewhere. By now. Can't tell if that's the wolf I hear or that's the buffalo. Some sword hits there. Yeah, it's taking a lot of hits here, but at least with the buffalo, it's easier to hit get hits on here than it is with the deer. At least with this method. Yeah, I definitely need a much more powerful sword than this, though. This is taking way too long. That's what the issue is here. Alright. There we go. Make sure the wolf isn't coming up here. Horns, meat, buffalo's horn, I didn't know. Alright. Yeah, there's a hunting. Another way to hunt the buffalo. Much easier with the melee weapon. Eventually, I will show a way to do it. It'll take me a while, but I'll show how to do the hunting with a bow and arrow when I get a little bit more practice in. Wait. Nope, I think this is a house, yeah. Yep, that's a house, okay. I think that's what I was thinking, that might be the tavern. So, go check a couple of these out. These might have been houses that I built. I can't remember. But as you can see, I don't have as much as much of a trouble with money flowing once you start checking out your taverns and stuff, and some of them actually start bringing in some money. It's just a matter of restocking and collecting, topping off the gold. Ah, here we go. This is, yes, finally, at least in this series here, this is the first NPC tavern, shop. Here we go. This is like a second tier one. A little bigger than mine, but yeah, you come up here. This is your storage area for this one. You can tell because of the sign hanging out right there. Yeah, the bad thing about this one, you really can't get into it as much because the NPCs pretty much take it up. And you get stuck in here too, so be careful on that. But yeah. So when you want to trade in another shop, you find like the bar. And you click on that there. And then these are the prices right here. So that's their goal, 943. First, I'm looking for salad. See if I can find salad seeds. I'm not there. But I do find salad. That's great. Okay, so cool. We're going to do that. Yeah, I'll take all of them. I don't know how many I just bought. But yep. And then I have a whole lot of stone here, so yeah. Alright, so there's that. I'll make the trade. So I think I got, if I'm not mistaken, I got 6 salads, is that right? Yeah, I got 6 salads. And there, can sell a little bit more stuff here. Up in the top here on the right side on yours, that's how much you would sell that for. So I just sold that. Sell these seeds. 32. 14 for that. There's 94. Let's trade that. That leaves me with 17. I got the main thing I came here for was the salads right here. So I can turn those into seeds and start growing salads for my establishment. So that's good. Yep. There we go. Azaleas. Where the azaleas at? I'll sell a couple of those. Oh no, that's too many. There we go. We'll do it. 40. Alright, knocked him down to 11 gold. Took most of gold. I got 1,866. But right there, you can see why it's good to have another trading post so that you can actually make some real gold there when you start trading. You're not just trading amongst yourself. I will have that eventually at my other place once I open it up, which is coming up real shortly here. I think I want to upgrade my my shop and tavern at least to at least the next size before I go and opened up to just build wherever they want. Cool. Yep, so there's that. So that's good to know. I also have a trading post here that I can come to. That's really good to know. Alright, so, all that, I didn't even check my own tavern. Let's go find the tavern. I need to restock it. There we go. Guys must be doing really good. Let's see. There it is over there. Very rich. 21 settlers. Okay. Yes, a lot more when you start putting food and stuff, and people got money. We'll start showing up more. Yeah, I'm not gonna go. I am all banded out right now. I just want to get home. Kind of sucks when these guys would be giving you other kind of quests, and they're all fixated on the. Yeah, they want me to go fight that wolf. I'm not fighting wolf just yet. Got the armor, but I definitely need a much better sword. Wow, look at this! I got a lot of meat to collect, and I've got gold to collect too. I don't think I put 500 gold, did I? Alright, so that's good. Yeah, special quiet. Put those in there. Oh. Rat's good. What do we got? Meat wise, we got rabbit and fox. Butter. You know what? Let's go roast this meat. This is where I was showing when you don't have your own home and you're in another place, you can go right in here inside the common house, I guess it's called. Where everybody shares, like, they don't have their own houses where they come to sleep. And you can just go on one of the tables, you can craft, do your crafting here. So I'm gonna leave a little bit for the meat pies. $1,563 settlers. Almost tapped out there. Getting close. Did it walk up on me? What I'm gonna do before anything happens, I'm gonna go sleep for an hour and make sure it saves. Because I don't want to lose my progression here. I got some really nice armor I don't want to lose. Alright, so deer meat, what do we got? Two on that. I haven't seen the deer meat quest lately. I gotta remember, it takes two of the smaller meats to make a meat pie. Alright, so now I'm all geared up for anybody in here? A new person? Hello? I'm not gonna mess with that wolf just yet. Oh! Oh wow. Alright, there we go. Meat pies, I think they're all gone. Get that. Oh, let's drop this. I don't know when I'll be back. Yeah, let's drop it all. As long as it's not over 10. One salad. Really don't want to part with that just yet. We'll sell one salad there. Let's see what's been going on here. So, oh, someone bought a berry pie. That's what it was. And then someone bought one of my vegetable pies as well. Okay. So they are starting to buy. This town's doing really well and they start buying stuff, so that's good. If it keeps doing really well and I get rid of that wolf, I might come back here and build a bigger. Tear that one down and build a bigger tavern. What? 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 I'm gonna go find out what that is. That's a new fleece over there somewhere. Where's the horse? Alright. I think that's looking where I wanted it to. You want to leave and come back for those trading clothes because eventually they will. You need to give them time to restock and re-up their gold there. There's a buffalo, but I'm going to stop the hunting for now till I can get more better sword. So yeah, the deers are pretty hard. Buffaloes are pretty easy. It's just, I think you see more deer than you do actually buffalo in the game. It's just been from my experience, it's been that way. Oh, that was a wolf right out there. No. Is he following me in here? Please don't. Oh, but look at this. Now this is something you can do. On horseback. Probably gonna regret doing this, but... So those guys, the guards, are the people who are coming around. They go fight that wolf. Now in the past, I've always been, I think, without a horse, off horse. Yeah, so he's hunting the horse. See, he's in the combat. There you go. He's fighting the horse. Or the wolf. So I'm going to try to go melee and help this guy out. Oh, he just killed him. I don't know if my arrow did anything to him. If he just died, that's weird. But yeah, this is kind of bad, what you can do after they've died. You can loot that, of course, take him. But anybody who's died, look at all that stuff! I got my salad, got all this stuff. I mean, he's dead, not like he's gonna be able to do anything with it anymore. But yeah, when they die like that, you can follow them out, and... You know, the only thing is, you have to make sure that the... Like, there's the wolf right there. Ugh. Make sure they're dispatched, taken care of. So this is a new town. I'm gonna go now to take care of that wolf. I don't know, maybe my arrow, the first one, maybe it hit it and killed it. I don't know. Let's see here. Alright, so what do we got? Anamatia. Oh, that's cool. 18 settlers, it's rich, 34 houses. Okay. And the best thing for me is, we have a lot of open space here in the main area. Alright. So we are going to build a tavern. Let's see, I want it right over here somewhere. You're wondering what I'm doing. I'm kind of putting it in there so I can line it up with the other buildings. And you don't have to do that. You can do however you want, but... I'm pretty particular about wanting stuff to kind of fit in, blend in better. There we go. Right there. Definitely should have enough of everything I need. So let's put some money in there. Yeah, that's good. And we have to go through and reset all this stuff again. Alright, so we buy the meat, sell the roasted meat. Okay. salt, peppers. Some torches. Iron, some berries. Definitely want to sell the roasted meats. Some of the bread. I don't see a lot of raccoon in this game. Alright, that should be it. So as always, gonna put the berries in first. Torches. Alright, put these down. Put the bread in. I'm gonna craft a couple torches real quick. There we go. 1598. Getting closer. That's not what I wanted. Where's that? There we go. Alright. It's all set up and ready to go. Yeah, if anything in this, in these episodes here, you're gonna get tired of seeing me do is just setting up those taverns. Yeah. Cause that's kinda how I make it fun for myself, is just, you know, having an empire to keep up and running. I mean, there's other stuff you can do, but, you know, in its current state, the game does have its limits, which you're maybe starting to see some of it. Still a fun game, still a lot to do, but at some point, just not enough there to keep it going. So for me, myself, I just make the taverns everywhere. Alright, I don't see another. Looking for a trading post here. Since this is a new place I've ever been here before, just doing a quick look around. Yeah, I think that's it. Okay. Also, they're gonna build, the NPCs are gonna build on whatever's the flatter side of the town, so if you see something really hilly on one side, you're not gonna find any or as many buildings on that side of the town, outside the town wall there. Even within the town itself, I built on a really mountainous spot, and, you know, I was only able to build on, like, 25% of that in one game, another game. There's another deer. Yeah, when I get a good sword, it's only, like, 3 whacks, and those deers are conquered. I think I only have a short sword right now at the moment, so that's all I can, nobody else is really making swords, so Eventually, there'll maybe be more swords I can buy and find in the trading post. And the other NPC ones, but I need to make it so they can build their shops. So maybe next time, I'm gonna make it back here. So maybe the next episode, I'm gonna tear down the tavern and the shops that I have in my one here, and I'm gonna in that same area. I'm just gonna rebuild them. We're gonna take up a little bit more space, but rebuild them and put bigger. Maybe the second level. Would like to do the third, but I don't think I can build those just yet. Let's see. What can I build? No, these right here, I don't have the ability. I gotta get increase my architecture negotiator level. So, but I can build these right here, the regular wooden tavern and then the regular shop, which will be fine. It's like the other shop that you saw before. I could build one right now, but it would be a second shop, and I don't want to do that. Let's see, anybody new here? I just as a quick little pass to see if there's anybody new to town that I can just introduce myself. But then have them hunt them down. Okay. So first of all, I'm just gonna offload. I don't need this stuff anymore. Keep the scans, these I don't need. That makes it easier. Wow. Yeah. What's really cool is like when you start bringing like new costumes and stuff like that into your shop for your little environment. You'll start noticing the NPCs, if they buy it, they'll start looking different, and they'll start dressing, having different clothing options instead of everyone looking similar. It's, yeah, it's really cool. That I love that aspect of that you can actually go do something. Wow, that made a lot of cool. Something that you bring in or introduce to your town, and then the NPCs will start taking it, and they'll start looking different because of it. Let's manage, see what we have doing here. I've been selling seeds, okay. I should probably take all the seeds. And buy leather, that's fine. Because I'm still making tons of money, so like that's fine, that's keep buying leather. Logs? I would, yeah, that's fine. Oh, and I've been selling the seeds, so maybe I'll just leave the seeds there since they're buying and selling them. An iron ore, yeah. Sell that, that's fine. Okay. The antlers here. I'm gonna go plant that salad for sure on this one. Is that a wolf skin? Cool. I think I'm gonna collect one of each of the skins. That'd be kind of cool to have. Wish you could hang them up and do something, you know, with them, and then just having them. Yeah, I can cook some of that too. That's gonna be interesting to see people start buying different clothes, start dressing up a little differently. Let's see if I can make any vegetable clothes. Vegetable supplies, what I got. Here to restock.
They knew now. That person.
Oh, I've got tons of meat here. And still about 200. That's cool. Let's see, what have I... Ooh, so the roasted meat? Okay, cool. Yeah. Man, I haven't been eating those pies, though. Let's go find the meats. Am I getting meat left? No, I gotta grill it all. Came while I was gone. Oh, wow. Yeah, I got three new settlers. Okay. Two new settlers. Is it two or three? Let's go find these guys first. Where are you at? There we go. So much better with a saddle, being able to just call your horse instead of trying to hunt him down and have him wander off. It's a whole nother world there. Oh, he's inside, okay. I don't know if I can talk to these guys. I don't think you can. I think you have to be... get off the horse to be able to communicate. There we go. Come here. There we go. What's this guy's name? Is Wee Waz. What can you teach me, Wee Waz? What do you got? Killing me? Okay, well, let's get that one for now. Yeah, these new settlers, you never know where they're gonna be. Sometimes if they just arrived, they'll be next to the billboard. Ezra will put them. Somewhere around that vicinity. But if it's been a while, they will just wander off. So that's a traveler. That's the guy. He's a traveler there. So we got him. And this guy, where is he at? The same area. Oh, I didn't see him. Hello. Okay, I'll bring you the wood, yeah. There we go, got a little more gold there. Oh, I'm doing really well on my gold. Okay. You know what, I'll make that my... when I do the next one. I'll go down to the... next episode, I'm gonna go down and just do the gardening. Do that. I probably will build a third windmill so I can do 15 wheat at a time. I am gonna start my little collection here, though. In here. Oh. Yeah, I guess I'll just put my extras in here. Oh, that's cool. That's a weird berry that gives me 10. It's like a special berry. So I'm going to turn these into leather, but I'm going to keep one of each. Yeah, so that's rabbit, buffalo, deer, fox, bear. Raccoon. There's a rabbit. Maybe a raccoon. Yeah. Oh, there's a raccoon. Rabbit. yeah, of all the stuff I bought and sold at my stuff, you can see that I'm only that fox that I found is the only skin that I got. Nobody sold them. So they're kind of rare, the fox skins. They're hard to get. Let's see here. Stuff I want to put in here. I think I want to put a couple of these in here. Give me 10. Healing. I'm gonna do some meat pies one of this, so I'll just save that for next time too. I'll do the salads, build the windmills, make some more meat pies, and then I think what I might do is I might continue this, I might do the hunting with the bow and try to increase my bow now to get a normal bow and just hunt with that. I think I'm also going to try to increase my blacksmith level next episode, so that I can have a better sword. That's going to be my thing. So it's going to be about upgrades and a little bit more hunting, I think, is what the next episode is going to cover. Plus those other things I mentioned. So, yeah, time to say we'll sleep for 8 hours. Time to say goodnight and Amia. Be safe. I will go ahead and end this episode. Yep, save. And I will see you in the next episode.
ただいま、全11地帯から925地帯へ向かっております。